blocked it. You know, I never wanted to be deep in love because I didn't want to get hurt. You know, I didn't want no crazy love or just bottom behind no woman who can't be. But learning to love Jehovah God and those 8 years of being single and allowing him to mold me into what he wanted me to be, you know, I had to put in a lot of work. I appreciate these brothers that took the time because I wasn't easy. It took like 6 different Bible study conductors to reach my heart. And that took 6 years, then it took almost 9 more years before I could be obedient. Because it just wasn't in me. It's enough, Jehovah, this fuzz, I want to go. It just wasn't there. But allowing him to really use me in the ministry and have the love for people, you know, because a lot of people say, why are y'all knocking on our door 9 o'clock in the morning? I look at them and tell them, you don't think we can be doing something else? We really learn to love our neighbors, as the Bible says. And this joy of getting to know the neighbors, and if we reach one person that wants to talk about God and willing to accept him as I need to make some changes in my life, that makes us happy. Because we out there really searching to help people's life better. Because I know if God can change me, RG son, GT, he can change anybody. And I appreciate it because learning how to love, I opened up my heart to love. And when I opened up my heart to love, you know, the same feeling. We used to ask, yes, how we gonna fall in love? You know, no contact, no nothing. I was like, I don't know. I don't have the first idea. But I thought that night and how to do it, and when I thought about it, I just said that I write expression or emoji and talk about how I draw close to God, made these changes. And when I kept talking about it, I was just being me. You know, I've always been a real person. Being real to me, I always mean it a lot. And I never wanted to be a fake man. I've never been a man chasing behind women, because I ain't giving them my money. I'm trying to make a
having you in my life. I wanna say thank you. Toni may wants me to tell the story how we got engaged. So real quickly, we had a family dinner, right? We had a family dinner. It was all them. All them. Me and my mama and Jehovah. So Gary makes the same speech, similar speech, and then Miss Doris says, but Gary, do you love her? Now, he had not said he loved me at this point. This was about a month and a half in. It was too soon, right? Do you love her? Gary said, yes, Miss Doris, I do. Where's little dad?
Right here.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm, that one. See, when we was growing up, kids were seen and not heard. Y'all remember that?
Yes.
Yeah, not today. So little daddy said, I got something to say. They said, what you want to say, little daddy? I'm like, you and her little daddy. I just met these people. You got proposed or what? All this attitude. I'm like, what is going on? He said, yes, I am. And what they don't know is that he had bought the ring the day before. And so he proposed and asked me to marry him in a month and a half. So I must have swept him off his feet. Are we doing the unity dance? No. Forget all that. We don't need it all. Let's do the couples dance.
So now we're going to do the couples dance and
walk with me, 'cause you've been away too long.
this girl, baddest woman I've ever known. This is the thing I've ever had, yes you are. And I want to thank you, baby, for loving me and changing me and saving me. See, I was lonely, but you came in and turned it all around, girl. The light of my life, yes you do. You're the song of my heart, the joy of my soul. I'm gonna love you, girl, I am. I'm gonna be good to you, darling.
Fellowship and meet each other and all of that.